Hello, I am Dr. Prashant Argade from Department of Pharmacy, Government Polytechnic, Jalgaon. In this video, I will give demonstration of using different tools in PowerPoint presentation. After watching this video, you will be able to use grid option for aligning text, graphics, flowcharts, etc. Design your own presentation template and install fonts in PCs or laptop at presentation place. Let's explore the different options. Grid is available in almost all slide presentation tools, but most of us have never used it. Please switch on the grid going to view option of that particular software. So here you can click here, view options here, and just switch on the grid by clicking here in front of grid lines. So make a checkbox here, then again click on guides, so it will provide the center lines, horizontal as well as vertical center lines, and switch on the rulers also. It will help us to place the graphics at their particular places. So let's have a look how to place image or graphics into our slides. So just insert a picture from this insert picture options. So here I will insert a department logo. Suppose logo is placed here and you want to place this logo at the center of this slide. So just select the logo and drag at the center point. So grid will tell you whether the logo is placed at center or not. Still here it is not at center. The center of this logo is not exactly center of this slide. So just select the logo by using arrow key, you can place the image at exactly center of this slide. Another options to keep the logo or images at center, just select the image, then click on format button. Then in format they are having aligning options, so just click on align and just click here align center. So image is becoming center. After that we want the vertical center, so just again click on align and then click on align middle. So graphics will be placed at their particular center. After that, suppose your slide contain more than one images and that image should be in one line. So if you look these slides, different images are not in one line. So by using this grid option, you can able to align all these images in one line. So just select one image and try to keep it in center by using this center line. Select second image, move the image at per center. Third image similarly, fourth image similarly by using downward arrow key. So this all are in now in line. Still there are some up and down. So in order to make it in line, so just select all the images by using this option. Just click keep the click left side and make a square box. So ultimately all images are get selected. So just click on format, then on align and click on align middle. So all the images are now in one line. So they are selected. So just pressing the upward key, all the images are comes towards the text. Now if you look out this slide again, the text are not exactly in one line and they are not in center alignment positions for the these images. So for that you have to first select all the text similarly as that of images. So once after selection of this text, so just click on format again, then on align, then align middle. So all text are now in one line and just drag it just below the all the images. So by this way we can make the all the text in one line. Now next point is this text should be at center of the images. So just select one image and select title of this image, go to the format option, align, and here align center, just click on align center. So see here that title of this image and that image are in aligning in that such a position. So you can do for same for all the things, align center, so it will becomes in line, align center, again click on align, align center, again click on last image along with his title, then in align center. So here this image has overlapped, so just pressing the right arrow key, that images are placed. So once all the things are in line, so select all the things and just press Ctrl G, it will give a group. So there is no need to select single text or single images. So once it become the group, so it will very easy to keep it in center alignment. Now this title of this slide and the images are not in good position, so just make the alignment of this title in center alignment. Still the center of this is not matched with the center of slide, so just click on this text box and just drag this text box up to the center alignment by mouse or by right arrow key, and after that just click on, press the control and click on this all images group, then go to the format options, align and align center. So now these are in one line, and after completion of this all alignment, your slide will becomes look like this. So everything is in one line, just above and below, so it will give a good view for the presentation. Next, suppose you want to give a flow charts. Suppose here I have take the example of limit test of chloride. So this, in this flow charts the steps are written here, but they are not in one line. So for that purpose you have to repeat the things, just select the all the text boxes, those you want should be in align, and just go to the format, align, align center. So everything is in one line. Similarly, select these arrows, go to the format option, align, align center. So after completion of all these steps, your slide looks like this, everything is at center place. So by this way we can use grid to make a effective presentation and give a good visualize effect for the our viewers. Next things, if you want to write something reactions or something text boxes places in front of the graphics, so that you have to use these grid lines in order to it will show effective way. For example, in this reaction, suppose these reactants are not in one line, isn't it? Similarly, in this product, they are also not in one line. So just click and select all the above portions of the reactions. After selection of this, just click on format, align, align middle. So all these things, all these three text box are comes into one line. Similarly, you can do it for product also. Just click on middle, so it will becomes like this. After that, just select this and select this, go to the format, align, align center, so it will get center alignment. So it looks a good, it gives a good effect for the viewers. So next thing we will going to discuss, that is how to design own presentation template. So just for that purpose you can have a new file for presentation. So this is the new presentation and you want to make your own presentation template. So go for view option, then find out in that ribbon bar, that is slide master. So just click on slide master, slide master. So this is your title slide. So you want to make changes in title slide, or if you want to place your college logo, department logo, your image into title slides every time, so just go into the insert option, picture, select the logo and place it at exactly center by using the same options. Again you have to aligning, now this is the title, aligning the subtitle styles by dragging and dropping. So if you want to change the font of this title. So just select the font. Suppose I want to select PT Sans Narrow. So it looks like this. Make it bold. Similarly, this is the title slide. Now if you want to logo of your department or college for every slides, so you have to add again from the similar procedure. So logo is here, so just drag and drop at exactly the position, make a size, it will match to the size of text. So if you want to change the font of this slide also, so just go to the option font and create an click here, create new font, theme font. So just select one font for heading. For example, I will select PT Sans Narrow, and one font for body I will select Open Sans. Just press save, so the all the font of every slide get changed. So by this way we can able to have a font also. So after that, it will, if you show the title slides, you cannot able to now change the position of this logo. If you add a new slide here, so ultimately your college logo will come here. If you again enter the next slide, again the same thing. And if you want to make a presentation by using this template to other places, so just if you want to record a video, you have to change the page setup, because this on-screen show 4:3 is suitable for the classroom presentation. And if you want to make video, so you must be select 16:9 or 16:10 as aspect ratio, so it will shows like this. Next is how to install the font at presentation site. So you must carry all the fonts, those are present in your presentation. Just open the all fonts, make a copy by clicking Ctrl C, go to the C drive, try to find out Windows folder. Within Windows folder, font folder is there, so just open it, font folder, and just copy by pressing Ctrl V. So that fonts are get installed into the presentation site. So here all the PT series and open fonts are get installed. So here with this we have come to end of this video. I thank you being here. If you have any queries, suggestion or comments, kindly contact me on the email address is given here. Thank you very much.